up you too. I figured we'll build this little mock foosball table I built. A lot of people were liking it when I posted a picture on Instagram. So I figured I'd give you all a tutorial and you guys could build your own. So here we go. Starting off with our base here, we're going to have a 5x8 base. And I'm just using some 2x8s, two of them, and a 1x8 because that's all I have to make the base here. And I'm going to take a 1x4 brick. Obviously, this could be any color you want. You want to place that there. Take a 1x6, put it right there. And then take your other, another 1x6, stick it over here. And obviously, this could be done in any variation of bricks that you have. I'm taking some 1x2s to finish it off over here. And then we kind of got our base built up. We want to have this high enough that we can still turn the knobs and have the little guys move on the sticks. Now I'm going to put a some green tiles down at the bottom because if you've ever seen these, usually they have like a green bottom in them, foosball tables. So I'm just going to place these in here however I can. I got some 1x4s. Stick them in here. And then I'm going to take some 1x2s. So once we got the base built up here, this could obviously be done with bigger tiles. I'm just using the ones I have. So we got our base built up. Now we're going to have to add a little bit more height to it. So we're going to add some plates. And I'm just going to take a 1x8 plate. Stick it on either side. It doesn't matter. I got one for both sides. And then some 1x3s. Just to get it up one more level, just so we have room for our little guys to move. And then we're going to take some of these 1x1 Technic bricks with the pinhole in it. And I have these Technic little pins that usually these come in blue or gray. I'm going to use gray. And you want to have those with the pin sticking out. Go ahead and stick it in there. We're going to use a 1x1. Here on the end where there's not going to be nothing going through. Here we got some 1x4s. Stick that on the end. Actually, let's take one of these and put it on the other end. That'll work better. There we go. And then we're going to take some of these. I already kind of put it together here to save time. You got this shaft piece. I'm not sure. Is that 1x6? Yeah, 1x6 rod. So you want to take those, stick it into that pinhole that you put the pin in. Then you got to take your clippies. These are like a 1x1 modified plate with a clip. And I'm using white, or not white, but blue and red. Just kind of the soccer players' colors. So you want to put one of those on there. About in the middle for the goalie. And it's easier to just put this on, like have one on one side, just pop it in the hole, and then pop down the brick like that. So then there you have your goalie, ready to go. And then on the opposite side, the handle is going to be reverse, and it's going to be a 1x2. So I already got that put together. So there we go, and then we'll just put one of these bricks with the clip on it on the other side, pop it in the hole. And there we go. So now we have the goalie in blue and two guys trying to make the goal there on the air side. And you just repeat this on down. We'll just time lapse this. So there we have this all put together. You see we basically do 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, and 1. If you've ever seen a foosball table, It's kind of, there's usually like more than that, but for this scale, I think that's plenty. And you can still move the guys. There's plenty of room to move them in there, which works out pretty cool. But just to finish it off, we're going to take some tiles. In this case, I'm going to use black tiles because that's the color of bricks I use here. And just run them up here in a variation of ways. Let's see. Figure out how I might do this with the tiles I have. Here we go. I'm going to take a 1x2 here. So there we have it. A finished foosball table. Minifig scale. You guys let me know what you think. I look forward to seeing the ones you guys build. And as always, give me a thumbs up. See you in the next video. Bye.